That's as big of a cobia as you'll ever catch anywhere you go. There you go. I'm gonna break their rod. I don't care if you break the rod, you needed to fight them.
Yeah.
He spit it, he ate it, spit it out, and then came back and hit it again.
Crazy.
Try to get a little bit better angle when I'm up here.
Yeah, back. Come up to the...
Come up to the deck.
Oh, what was that noise?
Sorry, y'all keep looking big fish.
Try not to grab too much above that handle, Dad. Oh my God, look at the size of that cobia.
He's probably gonna break my net when I go to net him. So I'm gonna need your help when we go to
got net. It.
Get it out by me. Get it out by me.
Yeah, like I'm on record.
Okay. You didn't touch anything?
No, I'm watching.
Yeah, I wish I had a gap. I need to keep a gap. I almost
tried to talk to the
pilot. I have three. I just never am killing big fish. You know, I'm always inshore fishing and stuff. So. We jumped a tarpon. We hooked like an 80-pound cobia. We got a 100-plus-pound blacktip.
You're the man.
No, we're just lucky. Make yourself a little loop. You know what I'm saying? Okay, I've got a massive cobia net too, but I like keeping the boat in this cobia season. Like you'll bump into them like this late in the summer, but usually they're most of them are up to the deep. He's getting tired. Like I if we had a gaff, we would have him in the boat already. But right now we got to get him like dead. Tired to be able to run the fish. Remind me to bring a gaff next time with y'all's luck.
Right.
Thank you.
oyster toad.
Look at the tail. That's.
I mean, end on a high note. You can't get any higher than that.